saved. That sucks. I can't sign in while I'm recording. Because I don't want to accidentally dox myself. So to do this, I'm going to make... First, I'm going to make a tiny little square. Okay, how big should the brick be? Not that big. Let's... Here to here. And delete all that. Almost perfect. Gotta size that down. Bit bigger. There we go. Perfect. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna have all our movement script here. So when this is clicked, forever. Yeah. Oh, what is it? It's that tiny big chungus. Oh yeah, I'm talking to my friend Sam. Oh god. Oh god. Listening to the Soviet anthem on piano. So now we're gonna do if key up arrow, down arrow, right arrow, and left arrow. Cool. So now if up arrow is pressed, we're gonna have to point in direction. Since this is a top-down game, I'm gonna do it this way. There's probably easier ways to do this. In fact, I know there is. I've seen a video on how to do it, but I don't remember how to do top-down games. So I'm just gonna do it this way. So right arrow would get rid of the right. This one would get rid of the right. And we want to move 10 steps. Let's see, do we move extra fast when we do that? No. Okay. Let's make it a bit slower. Let's do like 7 steps or something. Oop. 7. Okay. Is that good? Yeah. Okay. So let's create our character. Let's just make him red for now. Why? Gonna check in Discord. Yeah, I deleted my server, so is that what you want me to check? Oh, I just closed out of Discord. Sorry, I accidentally left. So, Sam. So we gotta add an outline in black. And let's make this a bit thicker. Let's size our character down. That's good. Now we're going to edit this a little bit. We're gonna make the character. I'm gonna do my best. Curved. Let's pull that down. Curved, and curved. There we go, a bean. And of course they're pill shaped, so gonna have to do this. That was in the right place. Here. Then gonna do that with every side. a bit smaller. That wasn't what I was supposed to do. Curved. Curved. And with that part, that wouldn't be too good. So, let's just... There we go. Control C, Control V. This over here. Then backward. Push it all the way to the back. And we're gonna have to make another block to get rid of the... Gonna just delete this outline. We're just doing this so we can get rid of this outline right here. There. Can look at the assets for assets, images. So what do they look like? So close enough. Let's make the backpack. Let's do the outline. Put it back up to 8. Back, and we're going to make this curved. And try our best to make this shaped like a pill. And there we go. We're gonna move this to make it a bit. There we go. Now we do the thing. Let's make this a bit smaller, just so we can, well, that's the outline. We want the outline to be black, so you want it to be filled the color I was just trying to make. Let's make this a bit lighter, like that, and curve. And these goggle parts of the spacesuit are also pill shaped. Let's move that over here. And we have our first asset. Let's slice that down a bit. And let's see. Yeah, that's pretty close. So now we're gonna write the code. So if you see this can move, but this guy can't, so we're just gonna make it. And if you don't know, in Among Us, we can actually, when your character moves upwards, they're facing the direction that you were just facing. So we're not gonna change the direction when we move upwards. So what we have to do for that is, So when this is clicked forever, then if we're gonna duplicate this, we're gonna do only right and left arrows. Right arrow and left arrow. And then we're going to point in the direction of the right arrow and left arrow. Right arrow would be in direction 90. And the left arrow would be negative 90. And we have to set the thing to left and right. Maybe something's wrong. So we have to flip our character. they stay in the direction that they're facing. Okay, now we're going to do forever go to sprite one. Cool. So now we have our character movement. Awesome. But they do have animations in. So we're going to duplicate this. Luckily for us, the animation is super simple to make. It's just this. Moving over here. We just gotta move a few blocks that we need to hide black lines over here. And then, let's undo that. And then this. And then duplicate that a few times. 3 times should be good. And then duplicate it. So then we're going to delete this. Duplicate this. Right all the way to the front. And we're going to move this forward. And make this. Just gonna undo everything we just did. We're gonna make this go forward. And then we just rotate this block to match that curve and move it down a bit. There we go. Then we duplicate this 3 times. Then we go into code. We're gonna do. Actually, I should have it in my backpack, but I don't. But I'm not signed in. I have to try to remember. So when this is clicked, when this is clicked, set, let's make a new variable called walk, set walk to 0, and let's see, I'm going to try to remember this to the best of my ability forever, change walk by 1, and if walk is greater than, we have to set it to 2, because that's where it starts. If walk is greater than, we're going to do 1 less than 7. So if this is greater than 6, then walk is greater than 6, then set walk to 2. Then switch cost, no, that's backdrop, switch costume to, and switch costume to, let's do costume, walk. Oh, that's not what we're supposed to do. There we go. So what we've done is we've done something wrong in the middle of. So we duplicate this. So we start. And we bring it over here. And duplicate this. And duplicate. So now. We have to update it to go to 9, which doesn't take that long. There we go. So now we have a better walking animation. But when we go upwards, this happens also when we stay still. That happens. So what we are gonna do is forever and then switch costume 1. So that means boom. But as soon as we start walking, see, but this just just locks us back at where we were. Because we're not inputting anything different, it's going to take us to our idle. So what we need to do is duplicate this and change it and delete, take out this part, and then if up arrow and down arrow. And there we have our walking. Okay, now we need to set up collisions. And to do that, we're going to take our character right here. We're going to size. We're going to control C. We're going to go here. Control V. We're going to make this cube as big as our player. Let's size this to here, then to here. We're going to make this go forward, like all the way to the front. Equal, and then we're going to zoom in a bit. Bring this over here. Make it so that it's as close to as big as we can get it. And then, all the way like this. We can, you know, just update this, so. Right here. I'm gonna try to size this to the character. There we go. So it's about the shape of our character. Now we're going to move this back to the center. And we're going to delete our character that we added. And we're also going to set... We're also going to set ghost effect to... Ghost effect. To 100. So now when we press this, you're not going to be able to see it. Now what we're going to do is we're going to make a block and call it boundaries. So now let's just set up a sprite that we don't want our character to walk into. Let's make it like this. Saturation like that. That's not what I meant to do. So press this. Boom. So now... We're going to go over here. In code, we're going to go to boundaries, and if touching sprite 3, then move minus 1 step. Okay, we need to repeat this. steps, and we're going to edit the boundaries block and do run without screen and refresh. So okay, what? Oh, my character is going past it now, because it's, I need to bring boundaries over here and see if that works. No, for some reason it just won't do the sprite 3 collision. Oh. Forgot to put forever boundaries. So now, can't walk into a wall. I do not believe that we need this. Yeah, can't walk into a wall anymore. So that's good. Okay, what next? We're going to do buttons. So let's see. Let's find. Okay. So I have this, so let's just go to Among Us. Just find a thing. So normally there's a use button and a report button. So now we're going to add those buttons. So the use button, as you can see, is a triangle. So we're going to fill this with that color. The outline is going to be completely black. The outline for them is pretty thin, so we're going to put that to 3. Okay. Actually, we're going to delete that. We're going to make a perfect square. Take this. We do our best to center it. Backspace. Backspace. Go here. Pointed. And there we go. Now we have this. Now, normally it's over here. Go right over there. And we're gonna take our text tool. The closest one is marker, so use. So it's written in black. Actually, I believe handwriting would work, yeah. Sadly, you can't outline it, so. But we have a way to fix that. We're just going to undo that. Control C, Control V. Make it white, center it, push it backwards, make it a bit bigger. What is happening? Okay, we're gonna press backwards, gonna make this a bit bigger. Not that one. Okay, now we're gonna press backwards. Gonna do this. And yeah, that looks good. Let's try to center this a bit more. So now what we're going to do is we're going to add that those little parts right there. That's going to be a bit tricky. Ooh, how are we going to do that? I have an idea. So, take this, Control-C, the fill. Delete it. We're going to Control V. First of all, we have to center this so we can center this. For this, we're going to take the outline and delete it and make it go all the way back. So we can do that. And now we can just draw lines from here. So like this. And this. And we're going to make, and then we're going to press this. And we're going to make them red. We're going to press backwards on these lines until they're in the desired position. I'm going to press back. There we go. And in the picture, that entire area is filled in red, so we're going to zoom in. And we're going to take our paintbrush. Fill, we're going to select this color right here. I'm going to set the brush size down a bit. A bit more. And then we're going to press, we're going to take this, press backward, 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 until like that, and we're going to zoom in, let's see, and that is it. We could recenter this a bit. We might have to get rid of that and just take text, U, enter. Oh, don't do that. We're gonna have to move this over here, size it up, make it a bit bigger. Set it down a bit. Size it down a bit. I'm never going to get that text to work right. Oh, you can outline text. Awesome. So you can just move this, delete the white text, grab this, center, and outline. And make the text a bit bigger. Okay. Most Among Us backgrounds are a bit dark, so we're just gonna choose a dark color. This should work. So now we have our use button. Nothing happens if we click it, of course. But we're gonna do, when this is clicked, we're going to set color effect to 50, and we're going to make it ghost effect. So when this is clicked, it's a bit dark as it is in the game when you can't currently use something. So, let's move this a bit, just in case. Now we need to make the report button. This is gonna be fun. Not very, but still. So, first we're gonna take this, black and make it like 3. Boom. Zoom in, center. Take this. Pull this out. Curve. Delete. Curve. Delete. Then we're going to make this like that. Then we're going to pull this in. And pull this in. And let's see, is that good? No, this goes out a bit more. A bit more sharply. Let's make that pointed. Yeah, now we're getting somewhere. So now there's a red band. Make that a bit darker. It goes right. Okay, let's see, where does it go on this? Right here. So now we're gonna edit this a little bit. And there we go. And we're going to make 2 more of these. We're not going to have an outline. They're going to be right here. And they're going to be right here. In order to make these look good, we're going to do what we did with the last one. We're going to Control C, then get rid of the outline, then Control V. Oop. We're going to do Control V, center it, get rid of the color. So we're going to push this backward, forward, and back. Okay, so now we have this. In the game, the shape right here is a bit different, so we're gonna fix that. The way we can do that is do this, keep that shape, and there we go. And also, there is a little line on it, so we're just gonna take this and pull that straight down. And there we go. I'm gonna move this a bit forward. That's right next to those in the game. It's right here, and we're going to group all of this, and in the button it is tilted, so and we're going to take this. Darker, put it like that, and put it all the way back. this pointed. Undo that. Ungroup all of this. We're gonna have to change that a bit. Extend this. There, perfect. And we're gonna pull this down. Pointed. You want to make every single one of these parts pointed, because in the game each one of these is well pointed. And there we go. So now what we do is we take this and we make the outline completely white and make it a bit thicker. So like 3. We're also going to size this down in the game a little bit, so we're going to take it to like 50. That's a bit too, still too big, 40. That's perfect. We're going to type in report. In black, and in the game it's all capitals, so we're gonna have to report. Now we're gonna do this, a little sneaky trick. Make this a bit bigger so that the white outlines don't look weird. And yeah, can't really see the text that well. We're gonna make this like a ton bigger than the rest. The stuff. You still can't really see it that well. Let's do full screen. Yeah, if you're in full screen, you can see it. And let's see. Does the last thing we did have a white outline? Yes, it does. Actually, I think it only has a white outline. No, it always has a white outline. So we're gonna take this.
Get in this room. In here.
What'd she do?
She was trying to eat Shelby's Pop Tart.
Okay. That's gonna suck. Actually, no, it's not. Just gotta take this, Control C, Control V. Wrong one, so undo. Control C, Control V. Undo. We're just gonna take this, center it, make it a bit larger, center it again, and make it white, and put it in the very back. And when we go in, white outline. this 50, and we're gonna do that. So now we have our walking Among Us character. And let's add a little bit more detail and make it a little bit more like the game. Never mind, because I already did all the animations. The sprites are looking like this. So, now, character customization. We're going, just to test it out, just to make a quick test, we're going to add a little party hat. Gonna add a party hat. Sorry, I was just thinking about how I'd make this, and then it came to me. So party hat. Just gonna make it yellow, because there's a yellow party hat in the game. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this, we're gonna delete that, delete that, and make that pointed. So when it's on, it's gonna look like this. Let's center this. Let's go to 0, 0. And we're going to take the code that makes this, go to that, and we're just going to move this above here and put that there. And let's hope that that didn't break our game. Okay. Oh, the reason we did the moving thing, the collisions without screen refresh, was so that it would all be done at once. So, no matter how hard the character tries, they can't go into that wall. Okay, so let's see. When this is clicked, that's what we're gonna do. When this sprite clicked, so we have to click this. So go to sprite 1. So now we are just going to edit this until it's on the top of the head. Perfect. Now if we click on this, it's going to go to our head. Now to make this do that forever, we're going to press forever. So we press this, and it'll stay on our head forever. But you may see that if we turn suddenly, it'll slip off our head a little bit. So what we do for that is we turn this into a, we're going to make a hat thing. And then, we're gonna do that, duplicate this, get rid of that. When this break clicked forever hat, we're going to edit this, and with that screen refresh. And hopefully, when we click this, it's really laggy now. Okay, why is that? Let's make it go to sprite 2 instead. Not sprite 3. Sprite 2. Okay, right now, it's fine. And as soon as we click hat, it gets super laggy. Why is that? Maybe we can't run screen without refresh. Okay, so go to. Oh, I know why I was doing that. It's because we were doing a forever loop for that, even though we already have a forever loop. So what we do is we just. So now we edit, and then run screen without refresh. Because it was doing two of them at the exact same time, and it was really confusing the game because, well, you can't make something that lasts forever, that's already going forever, go forever. So now we have a party hat. So now we're gonna go look at the hats in the game. Among Us hats. These are Halloween hats. Event hats. We just want the hats. I'm gonna get into a game of Among Us real quick, just so I can take a screenshot of all the hats. So you're gonna have to wait a little bit. 3:15. So online, find a game, just join a game real quick. We're gonna go here, and hats. Okay, so now if I go to photos, we can see each one of the hats. So hats, so we did the party hat, yeah, we'll do hats later, there are a ton of them. But at least I have it saved for when I need them. What is my phone at? 1%, that's not good. But, yeah, that's what we have so far. Now we're gonna make it so that we're gonna get rid of the when this right clicked. We're going to make it so that we're going to make, oh wait, we're going to say, we're going to make it so that when this is clicked, forever, if touching if touching sprite 1, because that's what we're doing auto collisions on, so it makes sense to do that. So if touching sprite 1, then we're going to broadcast near item. So there we go. So now it's gonna broadcast near item whenever we're touching that. So when I receive near item, set ghost effect to 0, 0. That means when I'm touching this, oh, what the? What is happening? That's because I have hat right here. So it's going to the thing. this is clicked, we want to go to, let's turn this off really quick, something weird's happening. Go to 0. We also have to do that for this when this is clicked. Go to 0, 0. Okay. So now that lights up, see? I need to make it so. Now we need to make it so. We need to make if we're gonna do an if not touching sprite one, then broadcast not your item. That glitches every game at time. Sometimes. See? Sometimes when you walk into it, it glitches out your game. So, we're gonna receive not near item. So it goes back to 100. No, not 100. 50. Okay, and I'm gonna do a forever thing here. If so, we're gonna go over here when this sprite clicked, broadcast message. Message interact with item. So now we're going to have to do when this sprite clicked, we're gonna have to do an if statement for if ghost effect equals 0. Or what I could do is just make this all a shade darker. So Control Z. That is not what I meant to do. Undo. I just ruined my thing. Well, that sucks. whoops. What I was gonna make a costume, because there's no setting. There's nothing for, I don't know. 750. We're just gonna speed run make it. Just gonna make it real quick. Do this. Write the text. Put it in black. Use. Get a bit smaller. Do this. Outline it with white. And we're not going to add the red thing again because I don't feel like it. And we're going to duplicate this. We're just going to fill. I'm going to fill this with a darker color. We're going to make the outline a bit darker too. So now, that's what it looks like. It looks pretty good. So now when this is clicked, we're going to switch costume instead to costume 2, and we're just going to replace all this with switching to costume. Duplicate. I receive near item, switch costume to costume 1, and when I receive not near item, switch costume to costume 2. There we go. And if costume number equals 0, when this right clicked and costume equals 0, broadcast interact with item, and we can just do when I receive interact with item. Then forever hat. So then we can go over here, click on this, it says 0. We have to be 1. So now here we go. When this happens, if we're close to it, press that, and we have a hat. So that will do it for this video. I'm going to have to sign off so I can log in so I can keep this. But, am I still recording? Did I record all this? Because if I'm just talking to myself, let's go here, and okay, so.